Dear students, welcome to the class. Today we learn about prime factorization. Before we get into the prime factorization, let us recall the definitions of prime numbers and definition of factors. Prime numbers, what are called prime numbers? Numbers which are only divisible by 1 and itself are called prime numbers. Example 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, and so on. 2 is divisible by 1 and 2. 3 is divisible by 1 and 3 only. 5 is divisible by 1 and 5 only. And 7 is divisible by 1 and 7. 11 is divisible by 1 and 11. Otherwise, we can define the prime numbers in this way also. The numbers which have only two factors are called prime numbers, like this only. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and 17, 19, like that, they have only two factors. That's why they are called prime numbers. Next, factors. What are called factors? If a given number is divisible by other numbers exactly, then those numbers are called factors of the given number. The given number is divisible by other numbers exactly, then those numbers, means the other numbers, are called factors of the given number. For example, factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5, 10. These numbers complete exactly divide the number 10. So these numbers are called factors of the 10. Among these numbers, 2 and 5 are called prime factors. 10 has two prime factors, 2 and 5. Then prime factorization, the process of expressing a number as the product of its prime factors is called prime factorization of the number. The process of expressing a number as the product of its prime factors is called prime factorization of the number. For example, 20. 20 is equal to 2 into 2 into 5. This is called prime factorization of 20. So how to write prime factorization? How to find prime factorization? Let us discuss now. This is a tree diagram method. 20 can be written as 2 into 10. 2 is a prime number, 10 is a composite number. Again, 10 can be written as 2 into 5. So here, 2 is the prime number, and also here 2 is a prime number and 5 is a prime number. Now we can stop. Now write all these prime numbers as product. You will get 2 into 2 into 5. Otherwise, there is a short division method. Take here 20. And which number divides 20? Which prime number divides 20? Among these 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, you can select any prime number which divides 20. 2 divides 20. So 2 1 ja 2, here remainder 0, and 2 0 0. This is the divisor, this is the dividend, and this is quotient. If you don't know to do this problem directly, you can opt one more easy method. Here 20 divides 2 divides 20. 2 1 ja 2, the remainder is 0, and 1 more 0 is there, keep here 0. So this is dividend, this is divisor, this is quotient. Now, here we write quotient. This is the quotient. So this is a dividend, this is a divisor, and 10 is the quotient. So this total process should be done in our mind. This is only imagination. So only you have to write 10 here. So now, again, it is divisible by 2. 2 5 is 10. 2, 5 is 10. Now we got here prime number, so we can stop now. So write the product 20 as product of this one, 2 into 2 into 5. So this total process should be done in our imagination. Now let us do one more problem. Find prime factorization of 30. How to find? I will show two methods here. 30 can be written as a tree diagram like this. 3 into 10. This is already prime number. This is a composite number. Now write this composite number product of two numbers, 2 into 5. Now we got three prime numbers, 3, 2, 5. So 30 can be written as 3 into 2 into 5 or 2 into 3 into 5. This is a tree diagram method. Now let us do the same problem with short division method. This is short division method. This is the short division. How to do this short division method? Which number divides 30? Which number? Which prime number? You have to take only prime number. 2 divides 30 or 3 divides 30. You can take any number. I will take 3. 3, 1, 3. So no remainder. So 0, take 0. Now 2 divides 10. 2, 5 is 10. Now we can stop. So 30 can be written as 3 into 2 into 5. This is called short division method. Short division method. Okay. Let us find the prime factorization of another number. Find prime factorization of 140. Now let us solve this one by short division method. Which prime number divides this 140? Only select prime numbers. 2 divides this 140. So 2, 7, 14, 0, keep 0 here. Now 70 is divisible by 2 and also divisible by 5. You have to select only from prime numbers. 2 divides 70, so 2, 3 is 6. 7 minus 6, here 1 will be remainder. 1, 0, 10, so 2, 5 is 10. Next, 5 divides 35, so 5, 7 is 35. If you don't know the process directly, you can do here division method also. Long division method. 2, 7, 14. Here 14 minus 14, 0. 0 is there, keep 0 here. 2, 0, 0. Now, this is the dividend. This is divisor. And this is quotient. This is long division method. So, write quotient only here. 2, 7, 140. This is quotient. This total process should be done in our mind. This is in imagination. Now 70 divided by 2. 2 3s are 6. Remainder 1. Bring down 0. So 2 5s are 10. Remainder 0. So 2 into 35, 70. So 35 will be the quotient. Now write here 2 quotient. 2 3s are 6. 1 remainder. 1 0 10. 2 5s are 10. Now 5 7 35 is the measure. So 140 can be written as product of these prime numbers. 2 into 2 into 5 into 7. This is the prime factorization of 140. And this can be expressed as like this also. Here 2 is multiplied 2 times. So you can write 2 square. This can be 2 square into 5 into 7. This is the exponential form of this prime factorization. So this prime factorization is useful to find HCF and LCM of given numbers. Let us discuss one more number. Find prime factorization of 1001. Right here, 1001. Among all these prime numbers, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and so on, which number divides exactly this 1001? Let's take first 2. 2 does not divide because the unit is 1. It's not even number. Let us take 3. 3 also does 3 divides 1001? No, because the sum of all the numbers is 2 only. So 3 does not divide. Let us take 5. Because of the unit digit is 1, it is not divisible by 5. If the unit digit is 0 or 5, the given number is divisible by 5. Let us take 7. Whether 7 divides this number or not, let us try. 7. 7 1 is 7. Here 3 will be the remainder, 30. 7 4 is 28. And 2 will be the remainder, 21. 7 3 is 21. If you don't know how to do this directly, you can practice like this also. 1001 divided by 7. 7 1 is 7. 3 is the remainder. Bring down 0. 7 4 is 28. And 2 is the remainder. Bring down 1. 7 3 is 21. So remainder 0. Here 143 is the quotient. That quotient should be written here. Now, it's a divisor, dividend, quotient. Again, which number divides 143? 2, 3, 5, 7. You cannot divide this 143. Only this 11 only divides 143. 11, 1 is 11. So 3 here, 3 will be the remainder, 33. So 11, 3 is 33. You can check here also. 143 by 11. 11, 1 is 11, 3, 3, 11, 3 is 33. So take this quotient and write here. Now we got prime number. Now 1001 can be written as 7 into 11 into 13. This is the prime factorization of 1001. You can write 1001 as product of prime factors, 7 into 11 into 13. This is the unique to the any number. So in this way, we can find the prime factorization. Now, I will take one more example. Find prime factorization of 72. So which number divides the 72? Is divisible by 2. So we can take 2. 2 3 is 6, here 12 is there, 2 6 is 12. Now it is divisible by 2 also, 2 1 is 2 and a 16, 2 8 is 16 and here 2 9 is 18 and 3 3 is 9. So 72 can be written as prime factors 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. This is prime factorization of 72 and this can be written as exponential form also 2 power 3. 2 is multiplied here itself 3 times 2 power 3 and also 3 multiplied itself 2 times. So that is 3 power 2. 2 power 3 and 3 power 2. This is the exponential form of the prime factorization. Now, in this way, we can find the prime factorization. Now, I will give some assignment to you. You have to try yourself. This is assignment to you. Find prime factorization of the numbers 216 125 140 and 180. If you have any doubts, write in the comment section. I will clarify your doubts. Don't worry, don't hesitate to ask doubts. Okay.